Well, summer's in full swing, so let's take a look at another summer-themed show, Air. Released in 2004 and animated by Kyoto Animation and based on the visual novel by Key Visual Arts Company. I can't really remember how I discovered this show. It might have been through a review, it could have been through a random recommendation, I might have even discovered it by accident. I'm thinking it might have been a review, but I truly don't really remember. However, what I do remember is I watched it on YouTube via fan subs first, before it was licensed, of course. The story begins with a transient named Yukido Kunisaki, on a journey seeking a girl with wings who flies in the sky, as mentioned in a childhood tale often told to him by his mother. During this journey, he arrives in a small village trying to make some money. There, he meets an odd, eccentric girl named Misuzu, a girl with a fondness for extra thick juice and saying gal all the time, who quickly makes Yukido her friend and invites him to stay with her. Though Misuzu's quote-unquote mother, she is actually her aunt and foster parent at the same time, isn't exactly excited about the idea. Yukido instead decides to stay in the town and continues searching for the winged girl his mother has searched for all her life. Things, however, get a little strange as Misuzu suffers an emotional breakdown as Yukido starts getting attached to her. It turns out Misuzu has a problem getting attached to people, which is why her aunt, feeling it's best for Misuzu's health, has never gotten much attached to her in the first place. Agreeing that it would be best for her health, Yukido leaves Misuzu never to be seen again as he transforms into a crow. There's also a number of side plots involving other characters, such as Minagi dealing with the death of her younger sister and her mother's rejection of her, and projecting this character, Michiru. One with this character, Kano, dealing with the death of her mother and an odd family curse. There's also a sort of filler arc dating back 1,000 years, but following Kana, a girl with wings confined to a place, and a friend, Uraha, and a bodyguard, Ryuya. When Kana is sent to another temple, the three escape and go on a journey to find Kana's mother, who is said to be tainted with a curse. They finally find Kana's mother, she tells them to leave. They all escape from the mountains, but their pursuers manage to kill Kana's mother. Before she dies, she passes the ancient prayer to Kana. While the pursuers are closing in, the three talk about something near the ocean, but Kana knows this is only a dream. She takes flight, but the monks curse her, and she gets killed by the soldiers. Ryuya and Uraha learn about the curse Kana's suffering, vow to end it by having a child who will break the curse. The first thing that really grabbed me about this series was, of course, the opening theme song. It's natural to assume an opening is what draws you in, but for me, the opening is just the prelude. Some openings I really love, others, frankly, aren't all that interesting, and I have no issue skipping them. This one, though, I listen to every episode. It's just hard to explain what makes this theme so great, but its musical composition and its arrangement just sets the mood so very perfectly for the show. It's not just the theme, either. The whole musical score is simply wonderful. Not bogged by a lot of J-pop-y music, it's fairly simple, but well-made. It's simple, but unlike other simple scores, it's actually very appealing. It's not just a simple piano playing or one or two string instruments. It's very atmospheric and moody. For a short TV show, the animation in this is just absolutely beautiful. You know, I just love this style from Kyoto Animation. It's bright and it's soft at the same time. It's not overly saturated or terribly sharp. It's just shining and glowing, and it just looks so pretty. The art direction is also really beautiful. The town is so detailed but still looks animated rather than live photo composited and cel shaded in. And my god, look at that shot! I'd give this show an Oscar for its cinematography alone! While the story does start out as being about Misuzu, it does focus a lot on the other characters in the story. I'd actually say we probably see Misuzu considerably less than most others. But I don't think the show suffers with its ensemble cast either. The characters all have something interesting about them. Contrived, perhaps, but interesting. It's actually in the last half we return to Misuzu as she becomes more and more helpless due to her deteriorating health. Haruka decides to make more of an effort to get close to her, but unfortunately it appears to be too late as Misuzu's father is returned for her. Misuzu, however, stubbornly refuses to leave Haruka, in perhaps one of the most tear-inducing scenes ever committed to film. And if you thought that was intense, oh boy, we're still not done yet. I'm serious, when I first saw this, I was crying my eyes out. I had to pause, take a break, because I was getting overwhelmed with emotion. In the last episode, Misuzu wants to visit the summer festival, but a storm keeps her and Haruka homebound for a while. When they're finally able to get out and enjoy the sun, Misuzu wants to make one final goal by walking to Haruka for one last time, triumphantly getting out of her wheelchair, walking, and finally collapsing and dying in her mother's arms.
Hey!
But if you thought I lost it on the mama bit, oh, you should have seen me during this moment. What can I say? I'm just a real big softy. When I finished Air, I finished what I felt was, at that point, the finest series I had seen. One of the most touching since Fruits Basket. Air was a really touching anime for me, and it has been for a lot of people as well. It might be easy to pick on the contrivity of the plot and the characters, and a lot tend to criticize it for its quote-unquote manipulation. But to me, that's everything good fiction does. It builds you with a cast of characters you either like or detest, and takes you along with this journey. I think art and fiction, by its very nature, is meant to be manipulative.
I don't know if the argument is made because the characters are overly adorable or have sad backstories, but I don't buy the pretty aspect. Take any Satoshi Kon film, which doesn't use the big doe-eyed anime style, and people still enjoy those even when terrible things happen to those characters. Maybe it's because the girls all happen to have sad backstories, thus instantly giving you pity for them, but welcome to fiction. Real life is pretty mundane on its own. That's why fiction amps up drama or circumstances to make it interesting. Even so, real life has people with all sorts of circumstances. You can take my life, which is pretty ordinary, or some people I know whose lives are anything but ordinary. Very few anime at this point have immersed me quite like Air. While I enjoy a great deal of many anime, this one truly draws me in and touches me in some the same way, be it making me cry, making me laugh, entirely making me recall on it fondly, or just other ways that I enjoy it the most. This is why I love Air, and if you're as overly emotional as me, you'll be sure to enjoy this beautiful series as well.
So, this series was licensed and released in North America by ADV Films previously. That is, since gone over to Funimation, since the demise of ADV Films. It's incredibly easy to find, and it's incredibly affordable. Funimation sets are very, very cheap, and they're really not expensive at all. I feel lucky and fortunate enough to own the remaining ADV prints. I mean, I doubt this is like the last or anything, but you get what I'm saying, of course. There is, of course, an Air movie from Toei. I've been meaning to see it, but I still haven't. It's pretty much the series just told differently. It actually predates the series, so, in case you're wondering. No real comments on the Air movies that way. Well, this has been yet another Shadow Blazer 3000 review. I'm Shadow Blazer 3000, and I'm signing off.
Ultra Happy.